Let's discuss about what happens when an electric dipole is placed in a uniform electric field. We know that a uniform electric field is a situation where all electric lines of forces are parallel and equidistant from each other. And here if we place a dipole, just for understanding and sake of simplicity, I'm drawing an enlarged view of a dipole. And say this is plus Q and this is minus Q charge, and this is the direction of dipole moment which is placed. And dipole moment is making an angle theta with the direction of electric field vector. In this situation, we know when the dipole is placed in an electric field, the positive charge of dipole will experience a force which is QE in the direction of field. And negative charge being negative will experience a force QE in the direction opposite to the direction of field. And as the dipole itself is a system, and in all it is experiencing one force forward, one backward. So net force acting on the dipole in uniform electric field, we can directly state it should be zero. It must be zero. So we can say directly, we can write net force on a dipole placed in a uniform electric field is this net force is equal to zero. Because equal and opposite charges will experience equal and opposite forces. But here we can see that these two forces are not acting along the same line. So we can write as the two equal forces are not acting along same line of action, these will produce a couple. And we know that the couple is a torque acting in the same direction due to both of these forces, which is independent of the location of axis of rotation. So we can write down the value of torque as in case of couple, it is defined as force multiplied by separation between lines of action of forces. So here the magnitude of torque can be given as force, which is QE multiplied by the separation between the two lines. Here we can write as d sine theta, because d is the separation between charges and theta is the angle between the line joining charges of dipole and the electric field. So it will be d sine theta, and here we can write QD as P. So torque can be written as PE sine theta, where P is the dipole moment of this dipole in electric field. And vectorially, this expression can be written as torque is equals to P cross E. Both of these results are useful for our further applications. So just keep in mind that the torque acting on a dipole depends on its dipole moment, electric field and the orientation of dipole, that is the angle between dipole moment and the electric field.